And on top of that, they also get the accursed Valkyrie combo. So interesting start here.
Very interesting. I can't believe they opened with Valkyrie accursed. I assume they're going to give that to Punk Pang again. He had an excellent performance on that hero, but and they're going to go Midas as well. I think Midas is an excellent pick. It's really strong against Tremble as well because you can transmute both him and his pet if they're linked together, and it's just a really easy way to deal with it because you don't really want to waste auto attacks and abilities on the pet, but if you can stun it, take it out just with AoE, it's really, really nice to have. And they did first pick Behemoth as well on BMG, so definitely valuing that hero high.
Yeah, you know, it is kind of interesting how things have just transitioned and changed around so much. I mean, Behemoth, that first pick, Accursed, the first pick on the Legion side you're talking about. I mean, who would have thought those would be the first picks at game number four of the freaking World Finals here of 2015. Cthulhu Final, we're going to see the elephant here in the end coming out for Bad Monkey Gaming as far as the third pick now. So Root of Z does have some history playing that elephant, so excited to see it in his hands. Obviously, Kinesis, the first ban now from MRR. Of course, you want to ban that Kinesis against Boxy if you get the chance. So,
indeed, I think they need to take out the Demented Shaman for sure. I expect to see them ban that second or third.
I don't know if they've really ran Demented Shaman before, but I mean, you're right. Obviously, it's a very strong combo, so that's going to be interesting.
It's just so scary, in my opinion, when you have a Cthulhu Fan already. It's just one of the more broken combos in the game. Incredible burst damage, lots of sustainability from the Cthulhu Fan.
Yeah.
And I actually don't know how many games I've seen of this hero recently. I'm surprised they take it out in game four. And I just don't like the pick, Bricky. I think it would have been a lot better for them to pick a boxy hero third. Whatever he wanted to play is what I would have picked here. Because when you go into these late rounds and, you know, grand finals, game four, you just lost a game. You don't want to pick something new and weird. You know, you pick what got you here.
Yeah.
And I don't really think Cthulhu Fan is what we know BMG for.
Yeah, that's true. As of late, at least. I mean, again, they have dabbled into it a couple times here and there, but I agree with you. It's, you know, on the verge of still trying to win this title here, and it's still they're up 2-1 now, so kind of comfortable in that sense. But the last you want to do is go into a final game losing the last two games, because that's I know you know all about that and whatnot as far as momentum in this series, so. Yeah, that is what's on the line here for BMG. So almost, it's not a must-win, obviously, but a win here to secure it would make it a lot easier.
It takes a lot of mental fortitude
to
lose games 3 and 4 and then win number 5.
Oh, but yeah.
I would – we'll see. The thing about this is obviously a more experimental draft from BMG. Mm-hmm. If they lose here, then I think in game 5 they will go back to their bread and butter.
Yeah.
I just wish they'd done it here. I mean, it gives me just flashbacks back to the last Super Bowl, you know, Seahawks-Patriots. Why don't they just run it in?
Yeah.
You know, just like at least give it a try.
Yeah.
You got two more downs left, and I know BMG, they've got a game, but this to me is just kind of feels like they're feeling some jitters.
Yeah, they most certainly are. So the fourth pick now for MRR going to be coming out here. Accursed, Valkyrie, and Midas obviously is what they already have. So the bans overall were Kinesis, Silhouette, Devourer, Dark Lady, Chipper, and Swiftblade is what it came down to in the end. So the fourth pick now, we'll see what that ends up being. I mean, again, as you mentioned, Punk Pang played the Valkyrie last game, so the idea that he could very likely play that again here is possible. Now, at the same time, Boxy, he still didn't believe it. He banned out both Silhouette, Dark Lady, and Swiftblade as other options for carry. So still thinking that there's that chance and doesn't want to risk it. Nymphora is going to be coming out here as the fourth pick now for MRR. And setting up some good ganks and whatnot. Obviously, a lot of global map presence, and
they
try to keep them scared.
They need to finish their draft with a frontline hero that can scale into the late game and output tons of damage. And I really only know two heroes that can fill that role. One, Zoogie. We just saw how effective that was. And the other one is Zephyr. And Zephyr, as far as I know, over the past, what, 3-4 years, is undefeated in the grand finals of a LAN event.
That's true.
It's always picked like once or twice, and it never, ever loses. And if you look at the heroes, they've got 3 heals, a lot of stun, utility from the Valkyrie, and they just, if you imagine their lineup just in a star formation, they need that point, that guide who just runs in and just absorbs the damage and deals out a ton of it. And I would be very, very surprised and very disappointed if they don't pick one of those two heroes. I mean, there's obviously other possibilities. They could go maybe Armadon, Berserker, we've seen have success in the past back in VDT's day. But there's really limited options for them to finish off their draft strong.
Yeah, 10 seconds remaining now. So fourth pick, It's going to be interesting to see where they go. They're talking about the direction. Okay, they go Torture for now. Again, Fusen's been playing a lot of that. It's a comfort hero for him as a support option, and going to go with it once again right here. So that still leaves that fifth and final pick to possibly be that tankier hero, as you're getting at. We'll see if they agree with you or not, or go a different direction. MR, their fifth and final pick.
Yeah, I'd be surprised if they take a while on this. I mean, they're either going to talk about it and, you know, just pick with a second left, which I would normally do, or in this situation, when you only have 6 seconds left in BMG's extra time, yeah. I would just rush through it because, as I said, there really aren't that many options here. Yeah. Like, they have to know that. Soul Reaper potentially could work, but I just think they need a strength hero or Zephyr, which kind of counts, and they need to just, you know, go in. Chidawan really likes doing that.
Yeah. He absolutely does. So we'll see that fifth fight. They are going to think it out, it looks like. They're talking it over, as you see on the player cam there. Again, they're huddled up. They've been doing that pretty much every single game, whereas I pointed that out last game. You know, BMG, on the other hand, they've stayed at their chairs and, you know, just communicating over Skype or whatever. But Ravener going to be coming out for MRR, and that's going to be their carry. Well, we'll see, you know, whether they run it more the initiator or the carry of choice here compared to the Valkyrie. Again, Punkbang played the Valkyrie last game, so...
I really wasn't expecting a Ravenor. I mean, the hero is definitely one that has a significant power level, and he does go in. So it fills the same sort of role as the heroes I described, but I'm not certain if he does it as well as, you know, an Oogie, for example. Yeah. It is, however, much, much, much stronger in the laning phase, and there's a Pebbles last pick. We've seen the hero first picked in this tournament, and they get it on their last pick. It's just going to be curious to me to see where they lane the Cthulhu fan. It might be a jungler, but I'm not certain. And I thought so. It's going to be a core torturer played by Krake.
Really? Is that how they're going to... No.
I lied.
I was going to say, that would be different, because, okay, Krake, he has... Oh, I guess, yeah, I was saying Ruta Z earlier, but yeah, this makes a lot of sense. Again, Behemoth in the hands of Ruta Z. He is fantastic with this hero, no doubt. And again, they like to do that whole pulling the creep wave into the jungle, of course, and farming with that. So it is going to be a suicide Cthulhu fun, it looks like, is what that comes down to. But it is also kind of interesting actually seeing it in Cracky's hands, and Boxy's actually playing the Pebbles here. But I know you actually stressed it earlier on today, too. Boxy, get him a playmaking hero, and Pebbles most certainly fits that role, of course. So makes sense here as all five are grouped up and head towards the bottom again.
Yep. They have very, very strong lanes. I imagine the Earth, the Behemoth is just going to be roaming in between the lanes. They'll probably block bottom at the start, secure Cthulhu Fan a little bit of a head start, and then rotate mid where he'll have a Torturer Pebbles to set up kills for, which is a really, really deadly lane. And then, of course, he can help the Tremble up top. But 1v1 against what I can only assume will be a... Midas or Valkyrie? It'll probably be Valkyrie safe lane, so I think it's an off lane Midas. Or wait, what am I saying? They're MRR. They're going aggro tri lane, of course.
Of course.
And what I liked is that they kind of bought into what I've been saying, where, you know, they picked their comfort heroes. They just won a game with Midas, Valkyrie, solo safe and mid, and they're going to just do the same damn thing. And it's the same matchup, I believe, assuming the Tremble goes mid. We'll have to see, but the main is just so different from back when I played, because I would have had no doubt Tort Pebbles going mid, but in this situation, they might be just tri-laning safe lane. I just don't think they win that lion.
Yeah. Well, it's, they are going to send the tri-lane up top here, then in four, Accursed, Valkyrie. Kind of an awkward tri-lane, really. I mean, again, Valkyrie and Accursed in itself in a dual lane is considered very powerful, so I guess, you know, throwing an M4 in there isn't the worst thing ever, but however, they are going to rotate away. So it is just going to be the Accursed Valkyrie in the end at this top lane, and Nymphora will head towards the bottom lane here. As we do see, of course, that means middle is going to be Midas, obviously, coming out. So as far as the Hellborn lanes go, you got Balthazar and Tremble at the top lane. Pebbles and Torture are going to end up mid, it looks like. And we got Behemoth doing the good old creep block at the bottom lane in that suicide.
It's an interesting laning decision. I mean, I like the Valkyrie Accursed top. They can apply a lot of pressure to Tremble, kill his mounds, no problem. It's just curious to me that Punk Tang is playing it, because he's been traditionally only safe lane or mid, so a little bit of a switch up here and just copying something straight out of the BMG playbook. I mean, they just lost to this, I believe, in game two, so not surprising to see that they have faith in it themselves. The Tort Pebbles versus Midas matchup mid is really going to be the telling lane. They need to kill this Midas, And it's very difficult because when Midas gets four, any rotation can turn into a kill very easily, especially on the very squishy Torturer.
Yeah.
And then bottom lane, of course, Ravenor and M4 can apply a lot of pressure. It actually is just an offlane behemoth. Cthulhu Font's jungling.
Yeah, that's true right here. So, yeah, that is interesting. I mean, seeing the Cthulhu Font jungle again, it feels like Bad Monkey Gaming has done a bit of this pure jungler from the start strategy here in Ultimate's World Finals. So, you know, not afraid to kind of change it up. They were notoriously known throughout the season as a team that just did not run jungle whatsoever. If anything, they had the secondary support route to Z that pulled the creep wave into the jungle and did it in that sense. But your traditional jungler, they did not do. They only started picking up Legionnaire in the playoffs, which was how they qualified, of course,
indeed,
for this event. So kind of interesting to point that out there. But top lane? Nope, Tremble's going to be fine. I mean, this is a tough time for Tremble, obviously. Don't expect him to get too much here.
Thing is, they really can't shut him down super hard, as he does have a lot of base regen inside the Tremble Mounds, but this is the thing about a curse. Like, he wins competitive lanes, but he's very weak boxing out any hero. So it's really just, it's in essence a 1v1 lane, but Valkyrie can't die. Akurs can obviously assist with denying a little bit, but Tremble should be able to get the same amount, if not more, than this Midas middle, who will do very well in this lane if he can avoid death. Like,
yeah,
that's the big key. Pebbles, Tort, they need to land at least one kill by the 4 or 5 minute mark to be able to snowball effectively in this lane.
Yeah. Well, we'll see if that that does come through right here, but you know, another Midas, of course, in the middle lane once again, 6-1 against the Pebbles, who's 13-6. Of course, Foxy has that babysit with him, so understandable that Pebbles is having a great time. In fact, I'm going to even chuck him right there. Do a little bit of harassment in the process. Bottom lane, though, short lane Ravager is what's going on again against the Behemoth here, as you see him now trying to at least get an experience range once again. So how's Cthulhu Font doing at this point? You know, 200 gold per minute, a little bit slower start, but to pick that up here. And, I mean, you expect this to be kind of a slow game here early on, or should we start seeing kills here in the near future?
It'll be pretty slow, I imagine. The only kill opportunities are really going to be on these Suicide Heroes, one mid, one bottom. The Behemoth actually could be in some trouble, but it's so hard. Like, you have Nymphora and Ravenor. Neither hero has a very easy to hit stun, and they need to hit a very nice combo in order to land a kill, as Behemoth is naturally tanky due to his being strength. He also went for the first item boots, so Nymphora won't really be able to, you know, orb walk him down. So I think this mid lane will probably be the most likely scenario for a kill. Up top, you can see Tremble. He's being pressured, but he's still feasible amount of CS, 9-6, Valkyrie 14-4, so actually fairly even if you count denies, and that's leading to a nice experience advantage already for BMG.
Yeah, you see that right here. Obviously both Cthulhu Font and Tremble are up there, so Tremble in fact hitting level 5 there in the process. 6 of the 7 Behemoth games have been suicide with an overall record of 5-2, as Quincy pointing out right there. Meanwhile, Midas, is he going to be caught here in the middle lane? I believe, no, he's going to be able to elemental warp away. And we'll be fine. Pebbles choosing not to go for anything too crazy right there, figuring that he could just port away. So no bloodlust kill just yet is where we will remain here. But again, Ravenor, I mean, what do you think about Ravenor carry as far as his potential and what Ravenor can do?
It's not bad. I think the nerf hit him a little hard. He can't, like, my issue is that I don't think he will accelerate in team fights like they need their core hero to do. Like, their late game is really just not there. Neither is BMG's, to be fair. I really would have wished they had picked, like, a Zephyr or an Oogie. Something that said, you know, if you take this game to 45 minutes plus, you lose.
Yeah.
And I don't think that they did that with this pick, but maybe they'll prove me wrong. I mean, Chidawan, he played a really good Oogie. Maybe he knows something about Ravenor that
I
don't. The pet is up already for Tremble, by the way, so look for that to start getting active. All they need to set up a kill middle is most likely the Ensnare.
Yeah, definitely. And again, Bouches are definitely very active with that Tremble, so look out for possibly setting up those kills that you're talking about. But again, Ravenor, most certainly we have seen it in the carryover before, but for the longest time it did seem like it wasn't that successful, but it did start picking up steam a little bit lately. And, I mean, its potential is pretty up there. But, yeah, not necessarily the hard carry that you're kind of getting at for MRR here. So, see how Punk Bank does, or Chidawan, excuse me, does do on the Ravenor. As pushing in the bottom lane up a little bit right here, so Behemoth is going to get some nice free experience as the creep waves up there. Cthulhu Fan's coming to bottom.
Yeah, he's also very far in on Cthulhu Fan, by the way. 31 CS. That's 4 behind the Pebbles and only 7 behind the free-farming Ravenor.
Yeah.
He's doing very well, and he's been controlling runes as well. He just ate a big creep, and he's just going to control the bottom rune. You see Torture already top with the shared bottle from Pebbles. He's going to take that rune. And rune control, really big, very important.
Yeah.
Midas can't really go for this bottom rune because he's afraid. He has no vision, and he has no idea where these big stuns are on the enemy team.
Yeah.
Do that level 6 as well. I mean, they're reaching a point where they can go for kills. They're 1,400. They're 1,500 experience ahead. It's only 6 minutes in, Breaky.
Yeah, and we're going to try to see that right here. He puts trample. No, misses Midas. Going to be fine. So, I mean, he had the trample, the obliterate ready to go. But in the end, misses the initial trample, and Midas will survive as a nice sidestep coming out from him. Nymphora placing down that ward of sight right there as Tremble, though, or excuse me, Cthulhu Fan does find him. And now comes the obliterate, so Nymphora is in a lot of trouble right here. Possible bullet skill coming out. Ravenor, in the meantime, going for Behemoth, but oh my god, he got killed by neutral creeps, and it could set up the bullet skill for Ravenor. Behemoth is trying to juke and jive right here. Cthulhu Fan trample will come out, and now here comes Pebbles as well. Ravenor, no, he's going to be stunned. In comes Midas trying to assist as well. Ravenor has the steam, is pretty damn tanky. The Chuck going to be used. Still no one dead yet. The finger shot and down. No, Ravenor. Yes, he will go down. Bloodlust kill in favor of Balthazar. And they're going to chase even further. Valkyrie going to be chased down. She will go down. What a job surviving there for as long as they did to eventually get that kill on a Ravenor.
Yeah, indeed. The Midas missed every ability there, Breaky, and then was and could do nothing. That's really the reason that fight went so poorly. Ravenor just unable to finish off the Behemoth, which enabled him to get off another Fissure, and that's what secured the kill on Ravenor. Yeah. Otherwise, he comes back in. His ultimate had about 60 charges on. He would have done a lot of damage, but that death in combination with not having the Midas hit his abilities, it's just, it's devastating, and that puts him in a pretty big hole, Breaky. They're down 2-1, but 3,000 experience, 1,300 gold.
Yeah.
They need some kills, and they need them soon, but Pebbles Tremble is some scary stuff when they have a lead.
Oh, yeah, especially Pebbles, of course. You know, he's got that well on his way to a portal key early on, a 700 gold saved up. You know, probably going to get some regen, so maybe not well on his way, but the point is he's having a very good time when it comes to his farm. And, yeah, you mentioned, obviously, the Tremble as well. But, sorry, again, he was having some okay farm last game, but was never really able to take off until later on. By that time, it just was too late, of course. So he's having a good start here. Look at the top lane. Yeah, Valkyrie. Steal some of the jungle camps there, but
he's only level 5 though, and that's the issue with this dual lane. I mean, Accursed level 5 as well, but it's really slowed down Punk Pong. And if you remember last game, he was super far ahead of the entire game, and he hasn't really had that start because he wasn't in that solo lane, so he doesn't have the experience yet to get solo kills. And again, he's up against like 4 strength heroes, Tremble counts, and it's just going to be a tough game for him.
Yeah.
He's sitting at 280 GPM. Ahead of the Tremble's actually ahead of him in that as well. He just doesn't have the farm to even win this lane. He actually can't contest him well. He does have vision. He sees the Cthulhu event rotating over, but still will be a very hard game to repeat his performance from game 3.
Yeah. Pebbles middle lane. I was going to say, I may need to be a little bit careful. There's just illusions there. If we see a curse is nearby. Could possibly go for something, but Pebbles does have Torturer nearby as well, so could be a backfire if they try to go something crazy. Darkstorm at the top lane, Tremble applying some good pressure to Valkyrie. Not going to be a kill, but just pushing him out of the lane. Behemoth's still level 4 in the meantime, so you're talking about being under-leveled here. Definitely in his case, he happens to be, but as a team, 3,700 experience lead. Torturer going to dodge the arrow. Pretty obvious that they have a ward of sight now. I wonder if that's going to be countered here. Maybe just let it run its course, but gonna survive for the time being as a result of that. And back to Pebbles as kind of expected. Again, he obviously has a steam piece of bottle. 1460 gold saved up. So I know something you especially when in your playing days, you really like to get, you know, the power supply of the bottle, a lot of build up items out of Pebbles before the portal key. Why is that?
A lot of times it was because we were often against dual lanes, and I figured that if you could go spend 500 gold to prevent just one death, maybe get a turnaround kill, it was worth it. But in this situation, he's just free farming the lane. I totally agree with his decision because this will enable him to get the portal key ASAP top. Valkyrie gonna dodge the stun to torture, so he will survive. But keep an eye on the experience lead. It's at 4,200 right now, Breaky, and it's going up like 1,000 every minute or two, and that's really scary for MRR. They need to make plays, and they need to make them soon. And they look like they will be going for the bottom tower, but Nymphora needs to hit level 6, and he just hit 4. This might be a tower, but still, they're in a hole, and they need to make stuff happen.
Yeah, 10 and a half minutes in right here. Behemoth is ready for that Fissure stun, level 5 here. He's got a block opportunity. Is that they? I mean, BMG loves to mass TP. They are ready to go. They're not going to go for it. So they decide it's best to just do what they're doing and let bygones be bygones. So again, a nice gold. But as you're someone, I mean, they were old there basically, you know, sharing the experience. So as far as that push happening, you see the experience is still quite a bit in favor of BMG right here. You see Tremble just solo pushing the top lane. Pebbles, he is going to have his portal key here now in any second because of the free farm he was able to definitely get right there on top of the good start that he's had. So in the meantime, Cthulhu Fawn, it looks like he's going to be going for an Astral Egg. You like that item choice?
I mean, it fits the role that he's playing. He's just sort of the just support me tank, so I think it's fine. It also just gives them a little bit better team fight, which is most likely what this game is going to come down to. I will say that Accursed is one of those heroes you don't really want to fight into, but when you have a Tremble, it helps so much because you have the ability to split push a lane and take more less concentrated team fights. So instead of just running around as five and just kind of mashing into the enemy team, you have the ability to force rotations and then take the fight with your global teleports. And Accursed is only level five, so portal key on Pebbles. There are four heroes you can one-shot on the enemy team right now. That's very scary.
Yeah. Yeah, he's that's going to be delivered right here. So obviously they don't have a clue just yet, but MRR very likely under the impression that his farm is probably pretty damn good. So maybe expecting it here in the near future. We do see middle lane initiation coming out a little bit. Pebbles, he falls back before too much happens. And actually, he still doesn't have the portal key just yet, I guess. Oh, delivered to the bottom lane first. And now coming over to him. So we talked about that Astral Egg going to be happening on Cthulhu Fawn here. 1,900 gold saved up on Balchazar in the meantime, playing that Tremble. So, but Ravener does lead the way overall. 400 plus gold per minute. Got the Abyssal Skull. And of course, a very powerful item on him because of the synergy there with his ultimate and whatnot. So roaming around, trying to find something. Going to come back middle. But again, we're seeing this from MR a lot. There's just a lot of grouping up. And it's once again in the middle lane now. And BMG, you know, split push from Tremble, and they're fine.
Yep. They have the Astral Egg finished on Cthulhu Fawn as well. So this team fight is going to be theirs for sure. They have a blink on Pebbles. They have the Astral Egg. It's so hard for them to lose this fight. And MRR looks like they just want to give it to them.
Yeah. They're going to fall back. Pebbles in the meantime. Big combo on a Midas and a Ravager right there. Midas will fall. The Shockwave to help finish him off. The Finger Stone gets the whole three right there. Tremble is here. Will it be enough for a chase? It will. Nymphora gets picked up by Boris and the assistants. And they want more even. They're thinking about getting more. Pebbles, Seaport, he's in. Ravener, he's all alone all of a sudden. And he's going to be collapsed on Trample out of him. Ravener's going to go down. And Bad Monkey Gaming, a huge fight here early on. 5-1 here, or 5-1 hero kill lead right now. Valkyrie comes back in. But at what cost here? Tremble with the lockdown with the assistance of the teammates. Smackdown kill coming out. And Tremble getting credit for the kill even. I don't know about that going back in there in the last second. But overall, Bad Monkey Gaming winning that fight big time.
Yeah, that 10,000 experience, Breaky.
Yeah.
14 minutes in. Like I said, they did exactly what they wanted to do. Like, that was the fight that they, that was their timing right there. They got the two items that really enabled them to take that fight. And Behemoth was level 6. I mean, Torture level 7. Like, there was no chance MRR could win that fight. Just none at all. And they started it the best way you possibly could. A blink in, toss stun on 2. That's perfect.
Yeah, no, that was that's the initiation that you're looking for. Obviously, if your Pebbles right there, and Boxy definitely came through. So this is a big, big lead right now, 14 minutes into the game. And BMG on the verge of trying to become world champions here of 2015. So still game left, but it's going to definitely be an uphill climb here, no doubt, for MRR. Saying that often here, I feel like. So Energizer is on a Valkyrie, you know, not much else with the team. But as I speak of her, the Caster's Curse. She is going to end up falling right there. Try to leave the last second. Wasn't going to happen, though. So the snowball is real for Boxy. He doesn't have any kills, believe it or not. He's 0-0-5, though, here in this game. But being helpful for the team. So, I mean, Nymphor is almost level 6. You think they're going to be able to take advantage of that, or is that going to be possible with their farm right now?
I mean, it'll be tough, that's for sure. I mean, who do they go with? You know, the Ravener?
Ravener, yeah.
He has an Abyssal Skull first item, Breaky, and there's no hero on his team that will set up for that Ball Lightning, and he's been missing them in team fights because, you know, you want to use it so that it can come up faster. It's got a really long cooldown, but with no setup, I mean, Midas is level 7.
Yeah.
They just don't have anything, and their draft, like, really depended on a hero that could go in, and Ravener, like, he's got 2 rounds of his abilities, and that's pretty much it, and with an Abyssal Skull first item, he's not going to accelerate. And, I mean, what's he going to do?
Yeah. No, that's true. That's very true. So 1,500 gold saved up again. And this is also the idea that, you know, Portokey is obviously very powerful on a hero like Router for initiation purposes. But is that the best item choice if you're playing more of the carry role for your team? I mean, to be fair, they do have a Valkyrie. But both those heroes are getting kind of those... They can be played as initiators and gankers and whatnot, or they can be played as carry, but having both of them, you know, we'll see which direction they go. But would you like to see the Portokey on Ravener or more of a farm build here? Or a carry build, even?
I'm not really sure. I mean, if you look at this golden experience advantage, it's now 8 and 12. Like, it's just skyrocketing upwards, and at this point, I'm not sure what he can do. I think the only choice for him is really to go like a shrunken head and just hope that he just dominates the team fight. Either that or maybe even a Dawnbringer. I'm really not sure, but he needs like three items, Breaky. Yeah. That's what he needs. And I don't know if BMG is going to give him the opportunity to get those. They get a nice ward up from Fuzin. He might have misplaced it. I don't think that actually it does not give vision of, like it to. But they will most likely look to push this top tower. And it's really not that difficult. You got a regen rune battle on the pebbles. He's level 11. He still one-shots almost every hero on the enemy team. And Nymphor is level 6, but what is does that really matter is the question. Because I don't think Midas or Accursed or Val can really get in the face of this Hellborn team with like a blink on pebbles. Pebbles has 1,700 health, right?
Yeah, that's ridiculous. He's hitting like a truck. He has 1,700 health. He's good to go. And again, the snowball's real. And then on top of that, they have a very farm Tremble now, who's just getting better and better, of course. So MRR, I mean, Valkyrie at the bottom lane, going to try to push out a little bit, but they lose a secondary tower in the process. Yeah, looking grim once again, but there is hope. MRR trying to force that fifth and final game. What would be 2,300 gold saved up on the Ravener right now, so we're gonna get an idea here shortly, I would think, of what he ultimately deems necessary. Valkyrie Prism in the meantime, and they're not gonna get anything out of it though. You saw Pebbles right there; he reacts more than enough in time, and able to get away before any of them get caught. So going back to now farm up the jungle a little bit. 17 and a half minutes in, and 10,000 gold, 12,000 experience. Jeez, puzzle box picked up by Cthulhu Fump, by the way. What do you think of that?
I'm fine with that. I think it's a great item. And it's, when you're ahead, it's just the best team fight item. You know, it gives your team the most. Again, I would have preferred a Sackstone. I almost always do. But Puzzle Box is not a bad choice. And if he can get the puzzle 3 by, say, you know, 25 minutes, I mean, that's your jungler, Breaky. And to have all that team fight item, it's so devastating. And I feel like they're just going to hit a timing and just look to end the game. I'm not quite sure what Tremble will go. I feel like he might just get a Shrunken if they're looking to end the game soon. Otherwise, he could just go a Mach of Brilliance. Why not?
Mach to assist on the charge hammer, a lot more farm. Yeah, that would be interesting to see.
I'm not quite sure why he would save so much money if he wasn't going for a massive item. But we will see.
Yeah, in this case, you know, maybe that Shrunken as you're talking about. But again, that's the case of, do they want to fight now or do they want to keep farming? So he's maybe indecisive, maybe not sure just yet himself, because, 4,000 gold saved up this early on in the game. That is ridiculous coming out for him. So see what he does eventually go for here. Pebbles in the meantime. He's got a Shrunken Head in the works himself, has that Mighty Blade here, and going to be progressing towards that shortly. Okay, it is going to be a right click of a Shrunken Head here in the end for Baltazar. So expected to start grouping up or making team fights happen now, and as you said, trying to finish this game here.
Oh, geez, blink on Behemoth. I mean, I like the decision. They're in essence just going items that will guarantee they win the next fight. And they're so far ahead at this point that they only really lose if one of their cores, specifically Tremble or Pebbles, gets picked off immediately. And they're so tanky now. Tremble with the Shrunken Head. Like, do you see any physical damage on the Legion lineup? Because I don't.
Not a whole lot. Not a whole lot other than those auto attacks. And maybe Valkyrie later on in the game is, of course, what brings up to the table. It's kind of the last game, but... Yeah, no, I agree with you. That's going to be a very troublesome having those Shrunken Heads here now on the Hellborn side. So going to be finished here shortly on Pebbles. In fact, a bottom tower kill. Ooh, that was even with Valkyrie and a Curse here and unable to deny it. So a little bit of luck there somewhat for BMG, but they'll take it. And even more gold and whatnot for them. The puzzle box, by the way, it is going to be level 2, I believe. I think he just purchased the level 2 pattern. That's the level 1 currently on him. The Warp Cleft purchased by Valkyrie is going to be turning into that, well, I guess the Thunderclaw. And that's, you know, he did go the Charged Hammer last game eventually. So is that the best choice, you think, here? I mean, Thunderclaw and Valkyrie in a game like this?
I mean, he doesn't really have any other choice. It's a decent item for fighting. It does pretty significant damage output. And it also allows him to just rice a little more efficiently. But like I said, he needs to join this Ravenor and just pick up like four more items really quickly. And he just doesn't have the gold for it. He'll need a loan from somebody because they're just falling further and further behind. And I just feel like BMG, you know, they're just licking their lips, getting ready for the killing blow. And it's 100 grand for first place, Bricky.
It's close.
Nigh on 98, close enough, we can round up. And they want it bad. They're going to do a nice build rot movement through the river. And there is a ward down that they,
to double damage Pebbles, finds the Nymphora. That's an easy kill.
Yep. And it's so scary to have Tremble Mounds everywhere because when you have a Pebbles who's this high level and so over-farmed,
yeah.
I mean, right there, oh, you're trying to kill the mound? Okay, cool. You're dead. And there's nothing they can do about it. There's the Thunderclaw finished on Valkyrie. Shrunken Head finished on Pebbles. So I expect them to do Kong, which I think they're doing right now, with the Puzzle Box minions assistance. And then they're going to try and push high ground after they take the remaining two tier twos.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, that's... Again, it goes back to the Thunderclaw pickup and Valkyrie. It's like, okay, Thunderclaw finished. So now what? You're going to go farm some more and enhance that farm? I mean, sure, it's that give and take. It's like, yeah, it's, you can understand why it makes sense because they are behind and need to get an item that's going to recover you. But when it comes to fighting it, and that's one of those cases too, if BMG picks up on that, they're going to really look to take it to them because Valkyrie right now, I mean, very squishy, only 1,100 life. And kind of the Thunderclaw not doing much to assist in that, of course. Now, Conqueror is stopped there by MRR for the time being. You see Conqueror about 3,700 life now, regenning slowly but surely. I'm sure BMG going to go back in though here shortly and look to actually finish it off. They will get a token on it. Tremble will be the plan. As far as vision goes, there is a ward of sight in the area from MRR, so they are somewhat aware. Not in the pit though, so they're not necessarily going to see the life here from Conqueror.
And there's no way they can fight in the pit anyway. I mean, you can see Behemoth's just sitting on the high ground with his blink ready. Yeah. Like he'll just we've seen him just win fights and games that the team had no business winning. And this is an impossible choke to fight into. Aegis is going to go, or rather, Token's going to go onto the Pebbles.
Yeah. I was going to say, they tried to Valkyrie Prism in, and that's, I don't know what they're thinking. I mean, they
nice
basically
fish,
played it as if they did not have Rev Wards down when you got to figure that would be the case. So. Easy pick up on a Valkyrie. Yeah, the Fissure Stone blocking a curse. He's going to stay alive a little bit longer because of the flame consumption, but he's going to die shortly after. So,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, jeez. S2's through the trees.
Freaking
I don't know
curse,
if that's going to help.
A curse doesn't die. That's how this hero works. Finally going to be picked off. And that'll end that. So 23 minutes in. Bad Monkey Gaming now on the verge, man. I've said that a couple times now, I feel like, but they really are. They really are here. 15,000 gold and 18,000 experience. And this Trouble has now another 3,000 gold saved up. They push the bottom tower in and going to port back elsewhere. So not going to look to go all out yet by any means. But yeah, that decision by MRR just wasn't the best, honestly.
No, not at all. I mean, it all starts with that first team fight, honestly. Like that really is the game-defining moment because, I mean, that's just BMG. Like, they're just an experienced, disciplined team.
Yeah.
And they got the items they wanted and said, hey, if they want to fight us, we're going to take that, no problem. They ended up getting a 4-0 in the tower, and they've just run away with the game. It's 10-1, but the real tell of this game is this golden experience because, I mean, they're just so far ahead, Breaky.
Yeah, absolutely. Ravenor, he's going through the jungle, getting what he can. Of course, in terms of farm, he has a Shrunken on top of that Abyssal Skull. So, again, in a sense, he's kind of ready to fight here, but not many fights going in their favor. They still only have the one hero kill, too, at 24 minutes in. So, you know, this kind of reminds me of I believe it was the first game, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, the Ophelia Dr. Repulsor Stratter. No, that was actually the other series. That's right. That's BMG versus, I'm blanking here. Myth, that's right. Anyways, point being, they had the Ophelia Dr. Repulsor. They just kept doing that. They were down by a lot, but they kept using that, and it's, abusing that and trying to climb back into the game, but it wasn't going to work. You know, this team, MRR, they don't really have something like that they could at least, at least we got this to delay and see what we can make happen. It's just simply they're going to have to make some big plays here is what it comes down to. So,
yeah, some big plays is a bit of an understatement, in all honesty. They need a miracle on Haunt Street.
Yeah.
17,000 gold, 18,000 experience. They still have the token of life for another 2.5 minutes.
Ooh, build rot.
I mean, BMG, he actually finishes an Nullfire Blade on the Tremble. I'm fine with that pickup, and we have action there.
Oh, he's going to hit him with Pebbles right there. So lag by. He dodged a lot initially. He's still dodging even. Chuck Otica through the Vaughn. On to Midas, that is. End up falling. So Midas lived a lot longer than he would expect, but But it's all said and done. Obviously, the end result was as expected. And now they're going to push in this middle tower. So Ravener, he's going to counter push the top lane as best as he can. But this is going to be a free tower kill for Bad Monkey Gaming here. And is that the last at our tower? It is. This will be the last at our tower at about 25 and a half minutes in. So BMG kind of returning the favor as MRR did to them in the previous game with a very, very big lead earlier on right now. And they're going to be pushing to the base. And, I mean, it's MRR, this is going to be tough. There's a token of life on Treble, a null Fireblade now. There's the initiation on Ravener. Actually, first down, no, he pops the Shrunken Head. He's going to be fine for the time being. Treble will get bursted. He has that Shrunken, or the token as we talked about, though. He pops the Shrunken as soon as he comes up just to fall back. So playing it very safe there does BMG. Don't want to risk too much.
That was a nice dunk by Ruta Z, but just a little bit of experience off of level 11, or maybe he takes some stuff out. And yeah, it's a good decision, you know, just pop the Shrunken, realize in retrospect, oh crap, they're not really committing to this fight. We should just run away, because why dive base? You know, that's really the only way they lose this game. They need to just play smart, play disciplined, and just, I mean, I don't want to see them wait for Kong. I don't think they need to, but it's a LAN final. They're one game away from, what, 95,000, 98,000, or not.
I believe it's 87,000.
87?
Yeah.
Wow, my numbers were off. I got them reversed or something, but it's just such a, they're so close, they can taste it. So
yeah.
Just play conservative. I wouldn't be surprised if they drag this game out for another 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Absolutely, it's, you know, again, playing to win here. That's what it comes down to, so do what you can. You see Pebbles, he's sitting here with the Invis. He is almost going to be opening. I mean, Force is nearby, but it occurs to him on the shield, realizing that. Is Pebbles still going to get a kill here, possibly? I don't know if he'd have enough by himself. And there is support nearby, so it would be risky. Boxy just keeping them scouting out here. So I wonder if he's actually going to still win the round. But again, there's a lot here, so it would be very risky. Ooh, the arrow is going to be dodged by Cthulhu Klein. A level 3 puzzle box, by the way, finished onto him. So Nullfire Blade, by the way, on Treble. Again, we saw that in the last fight. 2,600 gold saved up on him now. But you like the Nullfire Blade option?
I have no problem with it. I'm not quite sure what he's going to be removing. Maybe the shields? Oh, wow.
Oh, jeez. Free pick. Down the supporting cast. Oh, actually, middle lane. Ravener pops the Shrunken Head. He's going to go for the TP, and he will be able to get away with that. But the rest of his team now being chased down, it looks like they are going to get away as well. Accursed still has that ultimate of his, and going to pop it right there, in fact. Making sure to stay alive as he goes into the base and pops the shield on top of him. Pebbles, though, is like, no, you're coming back here, bitches. In the meantime, the ball lightning from Ravener on him, but it doesn't matter. Ravener just melted. It's like he wasn't even there. As soon as he went in, he just died. I mean, he didn't have a shrunken at the point, so understandable. And they're still going. Boxy, he dives into the base, basically near the well, and gets another kill before falling back right here. So Bad Monkey Gaming is starting to have fun with this, it looks like. Pebbles is going to be picked off, though. Tremble, he's also going to bounce a big shockwave from Red FC. Here comes a fallout into the bot, and Valkyrie's also going to fall. Behemoth did die, but they got what they came for in that sense. I guess Tremble did die as well. That was big, though.
That was really deep. I mean, he would have landed actually a double kill, but he might have teleported out just as Boxy went in for the toss stun. He would have had it too, and that's not easy to execute, especially on land and especially in such a split second. We have a replay coming up, so we can check it out. Pebbles, he's just going to chase in, lands a nice stun curse. They're going to take him out, but watch his second stun if we can get that far, coming up in about 20 seconds or so. That's what I thought was really well played. Ravener did what he could, but Shrunken Heads popped on both Tremble and Pebbles, and then there's really just nothing they can do. And watch Boxy go deep here.
Eventually, yeah, I see. He goes, well, it doesn't hear, I think.
Yeah.
There we go, yeah. Unfortunately, my camera work wasn't the best right there. So,
so close.
Yeah, so close, but so far. So, yeah, diving near the well, though, I mean, it's obviously always risky, so. Backfires a little bit right there.
I don't know
there.
If they really mind. I mean, Kong coming up pretty soon. They actually didn't lose any advantage. They actually gained a little bit. 22,000 experience, 19,000 gold. They're just in a really secure spot. And you saw the dunk from Behemoth nearly just crushed the fight even after they were diving tier 4s. So the damage output's just incredibly high. And until Ravener gets a charged hammer, they really don't have much hope in this game. Because, again, Ravener's actually going to die.
Is he dead? Yep, he's going to get caught in the middle lane by himself, watching him four-place a ward aside. Meanwhile, Ravener, he just gets jumped. And again, obviously, that's the item progression coming into play. He doesn't have a buyback.
Nope.
They're going to push middle. I mean, that's obviously a lot they're losing here.
I mean, you pick all the setup, all these supporting heroes, and then you pick Ravenor. It's just, if the hero's going to go first item Abyssal Skull, a very team fight support-friendly item, like, why pick the Nymphora? Why pick the Accursed? And I really think that that's what's hurting them here, is they just don't have anything that can go in and actually do damage in these fights.
Yeah. Rax, it's now exposed, of course, as the tower goes down. 15 more seconds for Ravenor. They're not even going to risk it. They say we can't fight with Adam. Why risk it? Let's the Rax be destroyed. And now they're going to have to worry about possibly defending botting because Cthulhu Vaughn's going down there. And it seems like BMG is interested in continuing to go. I mean, I guess there's no reason not to. They don't have a token of life, but it's they have such a big lead right here. So very confident. No, they're just going to apply some pressure. And then we'll fall back. And you're talking about another Conqueror, I'm sure. It's what we're ultimately going to be waiting for here. As 2,200 gold now saved up on Pebbles, on top of having the Shrunken Head Arcana and the Portal Key now. So a Hellflower.
Yep. Yeah. Either that or a YOLO Spell Shards, but I think we can pretty much guarantee that he'll be going Hellflower.
Yeah. We see Torch reporting back to base, regenning right now, so again, keeping an eye on that Conqueror, seeing when he ultimately is going to resurrect right here. As Tremble still sitting on the level 1 Nullfire Blade, it looks like he's just going to do that for the time being. He has charges, so. Oh, Shrunken Head popped by Ravenor. They thought they had a kill, but it was just an illusion. So unfortunately, kind of a wasted charge of that. Not only the cooldown, but that's now only 7 seconds it's going to last. So that can add up here. Post-haste picked up by Cthulhu Font, by the way. Jeez.
Yeah, I'm fine with that. I mean, his item slots are kind of full, to be honest. I mean, Power Supply is not the greatest item, but you really hate to get rid of it, especially on a mana-starved hero like Cthulhu Font, although he does have great items. He could have afforded to just grab, you know, a Sack Stone. But they already have it on Behemoth, so never mind.
Yep.
They win the game for sure now.
That's the item that'll win you games and win you championships. As Pebbles top land, he finds it in for a nice Zeal Stun. Delays it a little bit, but I think it's still going to happen, yeah. And Pebbles, though, he might be in some trouble himself. 5 seconds on the portal key. He's trying to dodge here. Has the Vivant coming in. He may just be forced to fight a bit. Oh, my God, he dodged it all. Well played by Boxy. And manages to actually get away right there. So, and yeah, team support coming over. And now they're going to stay alive and go for more farm, continue the lead here. Again, Conqueror is up, by the way, so it's time to head over there now.
And they are doing excellent. You just saw the stat come up, gold efficiency on Sync above 95%, and they're in just such a good position. Pebbles just farming away at the Ancients. He just picked up, I believe, his Hellflower complete. They're going to take Conqueror, and they're going to just go end the game, and it's been just a really methodical, precise game. The 18-4, very few mistakes, and their advantage has just consistently increased. If we had a graph, it would just be going straight up steadily. You know, Turtle wins the race, and in this case, they're really both, they're not necessarily the hair of the Turtle. They're more like the Turtle with a rocket shell, because they're just winning the game, and wow, here comes
the jump from BMG. Shockwave comes out, quick kill on a Ravenor. Down goes a Cursed. And now Conqueror is going to die. GG, well played. Bad Monkey Gaming are your 2015 World Champions here at the World Finals from Bangkok, Thailand. That is it. And look at the excitement. Obviously, a lot of money. Title of champion. Who would have thought? And there was a lot of concerns going into these World Finals that this would be the team to get out of the group stages, let alone win the World Finals. And, well, their title, they are champions.
Indeed. And it's really cool to see them. You know, young guys. First land, it's so cool. You can see they're ecstatic. Like, this is just what they've been dreaming of, and I'm really happy for these guys. They deserve it, and they played an excellent game there. Really nice way to go out. They proved that today and at this event, they were the best team, and they earned the champion's check and the Doombringer.
Absolutely they did. Yeah, the Doombringer, that's a big one right there. So, obviously, MRR, I'm sure, disappointed to an extent. Again, they still get their fair share, second place, but It's got to sting a little bit, and possibly for a while here. But BMG, again, I love their story too. They've been a team for so long. As far as the same five players, they've been grinding together for the longest time. Going into the season, you know, they were still fairly newer as far as, you know, really who are these guys, and here they are at the end of the season now, the world champions. You know, if I would have said it, who's Willowkeeper at the beginning of the season, not a whole lot of people would have been able to answer that, but they we know today has now BMG, of course, and look at that, man, getting excited once again, having some fun right here. So, champions Bad Monkey Gaming There you go. Winners indeed. Winners indeed. What an event, man. What an event. They only dropped two games overall, too. Both of them happen to be the bracket stages, but they get the wins when necessary.
I don't think if you polled, you know, everyone who came here at this event to work, I feel like a BMG MRR finals would have been like maybe 7th or 8th on the list. I don't think anyone expected this. MRR certainly thought to be maybe the 3rd, maybe 4th best team in Thailand, especially after the group stage performances by those stellar guys out of Group A.
Yeah.
And, you know, BMG, they just kind of, they never beat Sync ever. And they didn't have to, luckily. But, I mean, geez, you just didn't see this coming. And
yeah. That's a good point to bring up. You know, I'm sure a lot of them, when they heard Sync got knocked out, was like, whew, that's good. That's good, because no doubt Sync has had BMG's number throughout this whole season. Of course, Sync went in 7 of the 8 cycles, and they defeated them so many times. BMG just could not get over the hump. Yet, it doesn't matter. They didn't need to get over that hump, at least specifically. They get over the hump of being world champions and defeating the opponents necessary in the end. So big congratulations once again to Bad Monkey Gaming. They got to be feeling really ecstatic there. And we are back on us now. So with that said, we're going to be setting up for a closing ceremony here, I believe, and have some fun with that, you know, the awards and whatnot, and have most of the teams at least are still here and going to be coming on stage and accepting their awards for the places and whatnot. But it's going to be about BMG in the end, and deservingly so here. What about you, Kyle? I mean, what is this event fun for you?
Oh, man, I had a good time. I just, it's really kind of bittersweet to see another team in the spotlight.
Yeah.
It's been so long since I've had that joy as a player, and it just feels great, and I'm happy for these guys. I mean, it can't be understated how awesome it feels to win a LAN event, especially as you can see the big, huge crowd, and, you know, people just going nuts. It's really good for these guys, and I think they'll be around for a while.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's safe to say. And, obviously, with momentum after this, they're going to be sticking around and looking to make more happen. So that was fun, though. That was a lot of fun. Again, Bad Monkey Gaming grinding through the group stages, going 4-0, really surprised. Again, at this event, not only going into the event, but at this event, we're talking to them before as teams are, you know, the LAN Center the day before and, you know, at dinners the nights before. They seemed really scattered. They seemed like they weren't really sure of themselves. They were not really the most prepared for this event. They were nervous, and understandably so. But it didn't matter. It all came together on the days that it mattered, both yesterday and today, of course. And again, that's why they are the champions, and deservingly so. So, obviously plenty of storylines. As far as MVP, I mean, anyone on BMG kind of standing out to you? But, I mean, a team effort, of course, as usual. But, I mean, Boxy has got to be... Got to be a name in that.
I think Boxy definitely was the flashiest player, so he'll probably get most of the credit. It was really a team effort, though. I don't think anyone was a weakness.
Yeah.
I thought Cracky played very well. Baltazar was solid. Fuzan, obviously, was the drafter and captain. The shot calling was on point. Rudizy just played a solid game. He was turned into an offlaner a couple of games that series, and he did great. They really had no weak point. I think that the MVP is really tough to decide, but if I had to pick a player, probably go with Boxy.
I mean,
just because of the name, you know, it's his personality, and I really felt like the team, it's most valuable player. Who determines whether his team wins or loses? And I felt like when he was ahead and he was rolling, the team kind of followed suit.
Yeah, absolutely. That was definitely the case there. And, you know, as I was stressing earlier, this is a team that's been together for a while here. I mean, you have examples of that with Stay Green, especially, and whatnot. In your past. How important do you think that was that – as a result of winning this title here, why was it because of them sticking together for so long?
It's definitely important.
Yeah.
I don't think you really peak as a team until maybe at least 6 months together. And I think these guys have been playing for a lot longer than that.
Yeah.
It helped, and I'm glad that they didn't go through the roster shuffles that most teams in the NAE region do, regardless of what game you're in.
Yeah.
And this should keep them together for a long time. I wouldn't expect any roster changes, and you know, they still have a long way to go before this sort of victory can be considered consistent, but they definitely look to be strong challengers coming up in both the offseason and DreamHack Summer.
Yeah, yeah, speaking of that, again, Beef could do in the mentions there of the offseason, so still plenty of fog going to be just around the corner right here. And, of course, that DreamHack event, definitely looking forward to that already. But the World Finals, I mean, officially coming to an end here today as a result of the victory from BMG. And, again, in fairly decisive fashion, hey, at least it went a fourth game, but Bad Monkey Gaming clearly the better team, as they take it 3-1. So With that said, I believe we're going to start. I think it makes sense to probably go on a break right here, you know, let them set up and everything. We are going to, of course, try to grab interviews and whatnot, but we'll be back. The closing ceremonies, as well as some post-game interviews, going to be coming at you guys. Stay tuned. Congratulations, BMG, once again.
ครั้งหน้าเอาใหม่นะครับแต่ครั้งนี้ก็เอารองแชมป์ไปก่อนนะฮะ มาสัมภาษณ์ทางฝั่งของ Bad Monkey Gaming บ้างฮะ How do you feel about the championship game just now?
Feels super amazing. I have no words. This has been a great event. I had so much fun. We didn't really know what to expect when we came here, but it worked out great in the end. It was a lot of tough opponents, and we tried really hard, and it worked. So yeah, I'm super happy. Ruth, you
wanna? I am also super, super happy. I am super, super happy. I don't even know how to hold a microphone anymore. I'm shaking, and yeah, it's totally new experience. First time on LAN with this team. I love them all. It's awesome. There's nowhere I would rather be right now.
I'm sad. No, I'm just kidding. My voice is pretty good, I know. So yes, that's all I say.
I'm as boxy. I'm speechless, man. Wow, this is our first LAN event, and it just feels so awesome, so awesome.
Yeah, really amazing event, LAN finals, everything. Shout out to the crowd and the viewers and the sponsors. Thank you all.
Thank you so much and congratulations! Hey, ขอเสียงให้ Bad Monkey Gaming หน่อยนะฮะ เอาละฮะ ขอบคุณทั้ง 2 ทีมด้วย ให้ไปพักก่อนแล้วกันนะครับ Thank you so much ครับผม เดี๋ยวพักกันแป๊บนึงนะฮะ เดี๋ยวจะเข้าสู่วิธีการมอบรางวัลกันสักครู่หนึ่งนะครับ
ใช่แล้วค่ะ
โอ้โหดูเดือดมากฮะ ต้องบอกเลยครับ คือเมื่อกี้รู้สึกเลยฮะว่า Bad Monkey Gaming เขาก็ยังตอนนี้เขายังรู้สึกว่าแบบ เต็มที่อ่ะรู้สึกว่าฟินมากรู้สึกว่าแบบขนาดเขาพูดอะไรไม่ออกเลยฮะ
very very happy
ใช่ไหมครับใช่ครับเพราะว่าคืออันดับที่หนึ่งของโลกนะฮะคือมันไม่ใช่อันดับหนึ่งของประเทศไทยหรือประเทศใดประเทศหนึ่งนะฮะแต่คือที่หนึ่งของโลกแล้วอ่ะทั้งโลกนี้ไม่มีใครสู้เขาได้ฮะเป็นผมก็คงรู้สึกว่าแบบอยากจะกระโดดเป็นซูเปอร์แมนทันที
มันแบบฟินมากอ่ะ
นะครับแล้วเพื่อนๆคงรู้สึกสนุกเช่นเดียวกันนะฮะ เกมจบลงอย่างสนุกนะเพราะจริงๆแล้วอย่างที่บอกคืออาจจะไม่ได้ขาดรอยมากนะเขาแต่ละเกมเนี่ยก็มีจังหวะที่มันคู่ขี้สูสีกันตลอดนะฮะ
ใช่ดูไปก็ตื่นเต้นไปนะคะ
ครับเพราะอย่างแมตช์แชมเปี้ยนชิพเนี่ยเราแข่งกัน3 ใน 5นะฮะแน่นอนว่าต้องฝีมือล้วนๆอยู่แล้วนะฮะ
แน่นอนค่ะ
ครับผมแล้วลำดับต่อไปนะฮะเราจะเข้าสู่วิธีการมอบรางวัลกันนะฮะกับทอนทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอลนั่นเองนะครับ
ใช่แล้วค่ะ
เอาละครับเราต้องขอเรียนเชิญด้วยนะฮะสำหรับผู้บริหารที่มามอบรางวัลกันนะฮะค่ะขอเชิญคุณไพรัชเจษฎาวณิชนะคะ
Product Manager
แกมฮอนบนเวทีด้วยค่ะขอเสียงปรบมือด้วยค่ะเชิญเลยครับตรงกลางเลยครับผมโอเคฮะเราจะมาเริ่มจากอันดับไหนก่อนดีฮะเราจะมาเริ่มจากอันดับที่10ก่อนเลยนะคะครับผมค่ะสำหรับรางวัลนะคะอันดับที่10นะคะจาก
งานทอนทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอล2015นะคะนั่นก็คือทีมวีจากประเทศจีนค่ะ
ขอเสียงปรบมือด้วยฮะ
มาแล้วค่ะ
เชิญเลยครับทีมวีสุดยอดฮะต้องบอกว่าแล้วแจกกัน10 รางวัลเลยฮะ
นี่คือการแข่งระดับโลกนะฮะได้รับเงินรางวัลนะครับอันดับที่10 160,000
บาทค่ะโอ้โหนี่แค่ลำดับ10นะ
นี่ตามฝันหรือเปล่านี่อันดับ10หรือเปล่าฮะไม่ผิดป้ายนะฮะอันดับ10นะฮะเห็นอยู่ชัดเจนนะฮะสูงมากหลักแสนเลยทีเดียวนะครับเดี๋ยวแผนรูปกันนิดนึงนะฮะโอเคสุดยอดสุดยอดต้องขอแสดงความยินดีด้วยนะครับเรียบร้อยนะฮะ Thank you very much Team V ฮะขอเชิญนักข่าวก่อนนะครับ
ค่ะ
โอเคลำดับต่อไปนะฮะ
ค
่
ะ
อันดับที่9กันต่อเลยนะครับนั่นก็คือทีมเชียงใหม่วาเดนประเทศไทยนะฮะชื่อบอกไปแล้วนะฮะ
มาแล้วค่ะ
นี่มาพร้อมกับผู้จัดการทีมด้วยนะฮะประจำภาคเชียงใหม
่
โอ้ทีมนี้เขามีการคัดกันนะครับว่าเฮ้ยแต่ละตำแหน่งของทีมในภาคเหนือเอาตัวเจ๋งๆนะฮะเข้ามาร่วมทีมนะครับแล้วก็เข้าสู่เกมมิ่งเฮาส์ฝึกฝนกันนะฮะ
สุดยอดไปเลยได้ค่ะว่าเกมมิ่งเฮาส์นี่แบบว่าเจ๋งมากอ
่
ะ
ใช่ไปฝึกกันจริงๆจังๆเลยอ่ะเป็นอาชีพเลยแหละไม่ต้องไปไหนกันเลยนะฮะ
อยากเข้าไปอยู่บ้างไหม
ก็ดีเหมือนกันนะฮะแต่เชียงใหม่มันไกลไปหน่อยฮะคิดถึงบ้านอ่ะยินดีด้วยนะฮะ
ยินดีด้วยค่ะ
อันดับที่9นะครับผมนี่ฮะเชียงใหม่วาเดนนะครับต้องบอกว่าไม่ธรรมดาเลยทีเดียวเป็นทีมที่น่าภาคภูมิใจนะฮะสำหรับชาวภาคเหนือมากเลยนะฮะสุดยอดรับรางวัลเช่นเดียวกัน 160,000 บาทนะครับขอบคุณครับเดี๋ยวพักผ่อนกันก่อนนะฮะด้านข้างเลยนะครับ
เอาละค่ะมาถึงนะคะลำดับที่8นะคะ
ครับ
นั่นก็คือทีมยูมิดฟรองโอเพนแนนค่ะจากประเทศมาเลเซียค่ะ
ต้องบอกว่าชื่อทีมนี่เท่มากอ่ะโอ้ทีมยูมิดรองโอเพนเน้นนะฮะคุณเจอคู่ต่อสู้ผิดมาแล้วล่ะเชิญเลยครับเชิญเลยครับนี่ฮะประเทศเพื่อนบ้านนะฮะอยู่ใกล้ๆประเทศไทยของเรานี่เองนะครับโลโก้นี่มีเขาด้วยเสื้อใครเห็นโลโก้นะฮะอยู่ด้านหลังเสื้อสำหรับรางวัลนี้นะครับได้รับเงินรางวัลมูลค่า 200,000 บาทเลยนะฮะ
โอ้โหลำดับ8นะคะ
ครับก็ค่อยๆเพิ่มขึ้นเรื่อยๆแล้วนะฮะเมื่อกี้ 160,000 นะฮะตอนนี้ก็ 200,000 แล้วนะครับ
ค่ะ
เจ๋งมากฮะสุดยอดมากฮะเรียบร้อยมั้ยครับขอบคุณครับ Thank you very much
ครับค่ะ
You meet wrong opponent นะฮะอันดับต่อไปกันต่อเลยเยอะมากอันดับต่อไปฮะมุ่งสู่อันดับที่7กันนะครับได้แก่ทีมแคทเกมมิ่งมาไกลฮะจากรัสเซียเลยนะฮะทีมนี
้ว้าว
รัสเซียนี่นะต้องบอกว่ามีทีมเก่งเยอะกันนะถือเป็นอีกประเทศหนึ่งที่ชื่นชอบการเล่นเกมมากเดี๋ยวเลยนะครับได้รับเงินรางวัลนี่นะฮะโอ้โห 200,000
บาทค่ะ
ว้าวดีด้วยนะฮะโอ้โหต้องบอกว่าเดินทางก็เหนื่อยแล้วนะฮะยังแข่งได้อันดับต้นๆอีกนะฮ
ะ
กับ Cats Gaming นะครับสุดยอดนะฮะอาจจะใช้ลูกอีกนิดนึงนะฮะโอเค
ขอบคุณค่ะ
ขอบคุณครับ
เอาละค่ะมาถึงอันดับที่6นะคะนั่นก็คือ DCES Concept Coaster ค่ะ
ครับผมอินโดนีเซียฮะทีมนี้อินโดนีเซียนะฮะ
อินโดนีเซียขออภัยค่ะ
ครับมาแล้วฮะมาแล้วฮะเชิญเลยครับที่อันดับที่6แล้วนะฮะเราจะค่อยไล่ไปทีละอันดับเลยนะครับ
เงินรางวัลฮะ 250,000 บาท
เพิ่มมาอีก 50,000 ฮะเราเพิ่มหลักหมื่นไปเลยนะฮะหลักร้อยหลักพันเราไม่เพิ่มฮะมันน้อยไปฮะเอามันหลักหมื่นด้วยนะฮะ 250,000 แล้วครับตอนนี้อันดับที่6ต้องขอแสดงความยินดีด้วยจริงๆนะครับเรียบร้อยนะฮะโอเคครับผม Thank you very much ครับ
ขอบคุณค่ะ
ครับอันดับต่อไ ยอันดับต่อไปนะฮะอันดับที่5กันต่อเลยนะครับได้แก่ทีมสิงห์อีสปอร์ตเป็นอีกทีมที่แฟนคลับเยอะมากฮะ
ใช่เสียงเชียร์ดังมาก
กองเชียร์เยอะนะฮะมีผู้เล่นโดดเด่นหลายคนเลยทีเดียวในทีมนี้แล้วก็เป็นทีมชั้นนำนะฮะของเกม Hero of New World ด้วยนะฮะสุดยอดครับทีมนี้ก็เป็นการรวมกันนะฮะระหว่างนอร์ทอเมริกาแล้วก็ยุโรปนะสำหรับสมาชิกในทีมนะครับนี่ฮะแม่รับรางวัลเช่นเดียวกันฮะเงินเท่ากันฮะมูลค่า 250,000 บาทนะฮะ
ค่ะ
โอ้เจ๋งมากเจ๋งมากฮะเรียบร้อยนะฮะโอเคครับ Thank you so much Sings Esports ฮะโอ้กองเชียร์เยอะจริงๆกองเชียร์เยอะจริง
เอาละค่ะแล้วสำหรับลำดับที่4นะคะ
ครับ
นั่นก็คือ Snoop Dogg by Aza We Nitro ค่ะ
เย
้จากประเทศไทยของเราเองนะคะ
ว้าวเป็นอีกหนึ่งทีมนะฮะความภาคภูมิใจของเราชาวไทยนะฮะ
ต้องบอกว่าเป็นทีมดาวรุ่งนะคะที่กำลังมาแรงเลยค่ะตอนนี
้ถูกต้องน่าสนใจน่าจับตามองกันต่อนะว่าพวกเขาจะทำผลงานได้แชมป์หลายๆแชมป์กันหรือเปล่านะฮะ
ค่ะสำหรับเงินรางวัลนะคะในรอบนี้เท่าไหร่คะ
สำหรับเงินรางวัลนะฮะอันนี้คืออันดับ
ที่4ค่ะ
ที่4นะครับต้องบอกว่าไม่ธรรมดาอยู่แล้วนะฮะเราแจกกันแต่หลักแสนหลักแสนล้วนๆนะฮะ
แน่นอนค่ะ
เยอะมากเยอะมากนะฮะโอเคครับขอบคุณด้วยนะฮะ Snoop Dogg by Acer V Nitro นะครับ
ค่ะค่ะขอบคุณนะคะคุณไพรัชจตุรนิตนะคะตัวดักมินิเจอร์เกมพรค่ะที่ขึ้นมาช่วยมอบรางวัลให้ด้วยนะคะ
ถูกต้องแล้วนะครับและอันดับต่อไปฮะ Next May I Invite Mr. Sam Bradway นะครับ Director of Publishing from S2 Games นะฮะขอเสียบมือด้วยนะครับจะเป็นผู้ที่มามอบรางวัลทางเชิญตรงกลางนะครับและต้องขอเรียนเชิญนะครับคุณอเลนชูนะฮะผู้ช่วยประธานบริหารบริษัทไกน่าออนไลน์ประเทศไทยจำกัดนะครับขึ้นมาประกบคู่กับมิสเตอร์แซมของเราด้วยขอเสียงปรบมือด้วยนะฮะเอาละครับเราจะมาการลำดับต่อไปกันต่อเลยนะฮะลำดับที่3นะครับนั่นก็คือทีม MITS Hybrid Gamingประเทศไทยนะฮะเชิญเลยครับเดี๋ยวต้องขอรบกวนนะฮะให้คุณแซมให้เกียรติเราในการมอบเหรียญรางวัลให้กับสมาชิกทีม MITS Hybrid Gaming ด้วยนะฮะนี่ฮะเรามีเหรียญรางวัลให้นะครับ
ต้องบอกว่าเหรียญรางวัลปีนี้นะคะดีไซน์ออกมาสวยสุดยอดมากๆเลยค่ะ
ใช่แล้วโอ้เท่มากฮะเหมาะสมเป็นเหรียญรางวัลของเกม Hero of New World จริงๆครับคนละ1เหรียญนะฮะ
ค่ะ
ยินดีด้วยนะครับโอเคครับแล้วเราจะขอเรียนเชิญนะฮะคุณอเลนชูนะครับมอบเงินรางวัลนะฮะให้กับน้องๆทีม MITS Hybrid Gaming ด้วยนะฮะเดี๋ยวรบกวนทำการนิดนึงนะครับเซตถ่ายรูปมันสวยๆนะฮะเงินรางวัลสำหรับอันดับที่3นะฮะมูลค่าสูงถึง 300,000 บาทเลยเฮ้ย 600,000 บาทขออภัยฮะไปหาร2เขาซะงั้นฮะ
ครึ่งให้พวกเราด้วยใช่มั้ย
ไปหารครึ่งเขาซะงั้นเลยฮะ 600,000 เลยนะฮะเพิ่มนิดนึงครับโอเคครับโอ้โหยินดีด้วยฮะ 600,000 แล้วอันดับ3อ่ะ
แล้วต่อไปนะคะอันดับต่อไป
เดี๋ยวเรามาลุ้นดูป้ายพร้อมกัน
เท่าไหร่นะคะ
เยอะมากเพราะเราจะเปลี่ยนหลักไม่หลักแสนแล้วนะ
ใช่แล้วค่ะ
สุดยอดฮะทีมนี้ถ่ายรูปฮะเรียบร้อยนะครับขอบคุณนะฮะ MITS Hybrid Gaming ด้วยนะ
เอาละค่ะเรามาถึงลำดับนะรองชนะเลิศนะคะนั่นก็คือทีม New Lucian Esports MRR ค่ะ
รองแชมป์รองแชมป์ชื่อเด่นอยู่แล้วนะฮะ Made in Thailand แบรนด์นี้นะฮะ อ๋อ Evolution Esports นะครับของไทย
ค่ะ
ซึ่งต้องบอกว่าหัวหน้าสปอนเซอร์นะครับมาเองเลยนะครับ
ค่ะ
โอ้โหทีมนี้ผมขอเรียกผู้จัดการแล้วนะฮะพี่เห็นพี่เสถียรนะฮะอยู่ข้างๆเวทีด้วยยินดีด้วยนะครับคุณแซกกำลังมอบเหรียญรางวัลนะฮะให้กับสมาชิกทีมทุกคนเลยนะครับที่วันนี้พวกเขาฝ่าฟันกันได้ถึงแม้ว่าไม่สามารถคว้าแชมป์มาได้แต่พวกเขาฮะก็ได้ไปถึงรองแชมป์นะครับต้องบอกว่าสู้ได้สูสีมากเลยนะฮะแล้วก็เงินรางวัลนะฮะที่เราให้นะฮะสูงถึง1ล้านบาท
โอ้โห
ไม่ต้องพูดหลักแสนแล้วฮะเอาหลักล้านไปเลยดีกว่าครับโอ้โหเป็นไงล่ะเยอะไหม
เยอะมากเลยค่ะ
สุดๆอยู่แล้วนะฮะโอ้โหโหดจริงๆโหดจริงๆเดี๋ยวไงเวทีหน้านะฮะครั้งหน้าอาจจะมีโอกาสที่คนไทยของเราได้สมัครแชมป์โลกกับเขาบ้างนะครับ
ไม่ไกลเกินเอื้อมค่ะ
ถูกต้องแล้วนะครับขอแสดงความยินดีด้วยนะครับกับเดลชั่นอีสปอร์ต MRR นะครับ
เอาละค่ะ
แล้วแบบต่อไปแน่นอนครับผู้ชนะเลิศนะฮะในฮอนทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอล2015หรือว่าแชมเปี้ยนของเรานั่นเองไม่ใช่ทีมไหนอย่างใดนั่นคือทีม Bad Monkey Gaming แชมเปี้ยนของเราฮะนี่นะครับสมศักดิ์ศรีจริงๆสุดยอดของสุดยอดฮะโอ้สู้ได้มันมากแรงดีไม่มีตกเลยบอกเลยครับเดี๋ยวมอบเหรียญรางวัลกันก่อนนะฮะแน่นอนต้องเป็นเหรียญทองจากการแข่งขันในทัวร์นาเมนต์นี้นะครับ
ค
่
ะ
สุดสุดยอดครับเอาละครับโอ้โหเดี๋ยวมอบเหรียญถ่ายรูปกันรูปหนึ่งถ่ายรูปหนึ่งกันเดี๋ยวเราจะชักดาบกันต่อนะฮะถ่ายรูปกันแล้วกันโอเคครับ next BNY team Bad Monkey GamingTo the toughest stand. And before you pull the sword, I will give you a signal. Counting down. 3, 2, 1. Champion of our club, Bad Monkey Gaming. Oh, good job. We are team champion. Welcome to the On Tour World Final 2015.Congratulation นะโอเคครับแล้วเดี๋ยวต่อไปนะเราขอเชิญคุณอเลนนะฮะมอบรางวัลที่ด้านบนเลยนะครับขอเชิญฮะขอเชิญนะครับด้านบนเลยครับคุณอเลนครับด้านบนเลยครับ
สำหรับแชมเปี้ยนนะคะได้เงินรางวัลทั้งมูลค่าถึง2,800,000 บาทค่ะ
แต่3ล้านแล้วนะฮะสุดยอดสุดยอดฮะโอเคเราถ่ายรูปแชมป์กันก่อนฮะเอาให้เสร็จก่อนนะครับพี่สื่อมวลชนขอเชิญนะครับเดี๋ยวกล้องตรงกลางนะฮะ Center Camera โอเคเชิญเลยนะครับเชิญเลยนะครับถ่ายรูปเลยนะฮะทีมแชมป์ฮอนทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอล2015นะฮะเฮ้ Come on guys 1 2 3 hey ดูท่าเขามันมากเขาใช้เหนื่อยเรื่องนี้ต้องขอเชิญนะฮะที่ได้รางวัลทั้งหมดนะฮะถ่ายรูปร่วมกันบนเวทีเลยนะฮะขอเชิญนะครับเดี๋ยวขอเชิญทีมแชมป์ของเรานะฮะชั้น2เลยนะครับเลยนะครับทั้ง10ทีมนะฮะที่ได้รางวัลนะครับ ได้รางวัลนะฮะเชิญเลยนะครับแล้วมาถ่ายรูปรวมกันนะฮะต้องบอกว่าเต็มเวทีแน่นอนฮะเพราะว่าทีมเยอะมากฮะเดี๋ยวให้ทีมงานเราจัดนิดนึงมาขอเวลาหน่อยนะฮะส่วนพี่ๆช่างภาพนะฮะแล้วก็สื่อมวลชนนะครับใครจะถ่ายเนี่ยโอ้รอคิวถ่ายสุดท้ายนี่เดี๋ยวถ่ายกันให้เต็มที่เลยนะฮะเดี๋ยวขอจัดคิวนิดนึงจะได้สวยๆนะฮะ
สำหรับเพื่อนๆที่อยู่ตรงนี้นะคะก็อย่าเพิ่งกลับนะคะเพราะว่าหลังจากนี้นะคะเราก็ยังมีลัคกี้ดรออยู่เหมือนเดิมค
่
ะ
ใช่ที่บอกกันไว้นะฮะกลับก่อนเสียใจแย่เลยนะฮะตอนนี้นะครับใครที่มีป้ายบล็อกอัพกันรางวัลนะฮะเดี๋ยวอย่าลืมชูกันด้วยนะฮะต้องบอกว่า10ทีมสุดท้ายนี่นะครับในทีมจากประเทศไทยนะฮะเข้ามาถึง3ทีมด้วยกันนะครับ
โอ
้4ทีมไม่ให้จริงแล้วถ้าเกิด10อันดับนี่นะฮะเขาบอกว่าเยอะมากนะเป็นประวัติศาสตร์ของวงการฮอร์ไทยเลยนะฮะกล้องเยอะมากฮะถ่ายได้เต็มที่เลยนะครับเชิญเลยนะครับทั้งสื่อมวลชนจากประเทศไทยแล้วก็สื่อมวลชนจากต่างประเทศนะครับเอาเลยฮะถ่ายให้เต็มที่นะครับนี่คือบทสรุปของการแข่งขันฮอร์ทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอล2015นะฮะแต่ละทีมที่อยู่บนเวทีนี้นะครับต่างโชว์ผลงานได้อย่างโดดเด่นนะฮะถึงแม้ว่าบางทีอาจจะพลาดรางวัลที่สูงกว่านี้แต่ผมบอกได้เลยว่าไม่ธรรมดาฮะเอาอีกทีเดี๋ยวให้สัญญาณให้เดี๋ยวให้สัญญาณให้ครับ2 3โอ้มันมากเลยฮะพี่ช่างภาพคนนี้ฮะโอเคอีกโอเคเดี๋ยวให้สัญญาณ1 2 3
เย
้เย้สุดยอดมันดีตอนจบนะฮะบอกเลยนะฮะเอามีใครอยากเก็บภาพเชิญเลยฮะเชิญให้เวลาแป๊บเดียวนะฮะอีกนิดนึงนะฮะเชิญเลยนะครับบายบายผมบายบายฮะยอดมันมากเจอแล้วฮะอีกนิดนึงฮะ almost
จบเป็นแบบยิ่งใหญ่นะคะวันนี
้ครับไม่ต้องห่วงฮะว่าการแข่งเราเนี่ยจะไม่จบที่การแข่งนี้เริ่มเกมฮอร์ในปีนี้จะมีการแข่งอยู่เรื่อยๆนะฮะติดตามกันได้นะสำหรับแฟนฮอร์ไทยนะครับเรียบร้อยไหมฮะพี่สื่อมวลชนทุกท่านครับอีกนิดนึงหมดหรือยังเอ่ยหมดแล้วนะอ่ะอีกรูป one more last shot two three yeah thank you ขอบคุณทุกคนมากเลยนะครับผมต้องขอแสดงความดีกับทุกทีมด้วยขอเสียงปรบมือกับทั้ง10ทีมด้วยครับขอเชิญพักผ่อนก่อนนะฮะต้องขอขอบคุณด้วยนะฮะค
ุ
ณแซมแรดเวดนะครับคุณอเลนชูนะฮะ
ค่ะคุณไพรัชเจริญวณิชด้วยค่ะ
ขอบคุณนะฮะรวมไปถึงขอแสดงความดีกับทั้ง10ทีมด้วยนะฮะไม่ธรรมดาเลยทีเดียวนะฮะสนุกสนานเร้าใจสุดๆ
ผมบอกตรงนี้เลยตลอดเวลาเลยค่ะ
ได้ครับมันมากฮะ
นานนะอย่างที่บอกกันนะอย่าเพิ่งไปไหนนะคะใครที่อยู่ในหอแห่งนี้นะคะ
ใช่ต้องบอกตอนนี้เวทีเต็มไปด้วยเศษกระดาษที่เมื่อกี้ยิงบูมขึ้นมานะฮะ
ค
่
ะ
อะไรนั่งที่บอกว่าอย่าเพิ่งไปไหนนะทุกคนครับเดี๋ยวจะมีลัคกี้ดอกกันอดทนรอกันอีกสักครู่เดียวเรียกว่าอดทนไม่ดีนะเรียกว่าอดใจรอดีกว่านะฮ
ะ
เราได้ลุ้นรางวัลกันนะครับแต่ว่าเพื่อนๆทางบ้านครับผมต้องขอแจ้งนิดนึงนะฮะเดี๋ยวเพื่อนๆทางบ้านนะครับเราจะลากันไปนะฮะพร้อมๆกับการประมวลภาพการแข่งขันของฮอร์นทัวร์เวิลด์ไฟนอล2015กันนะฮะยังไงนะครับต้องขอขอบคุณทางบ้านที่ติดตามด้วยนะฮะแล้วเจอกันใหม่โอกาสหน้าทางบ้านนะฮะสวัสดีครับ
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Bangkok, Thailand. I've got with me a champion, one of the members of Bad Monkey Gaming, your winners of the Honchua World Finals, Mr. Root of Z. Root, a championship. Your first time at a LAN. What was it like being up on that stage?
I'm not sure how to describe it. Because at first, it was just like, there was just a screen in front of me, and we were just playing our game. And then when we got like two wins, all of a sudden, like the whole crowd was like alive in front of me, and I saw every face in the crowd. And I think we played pretty bad in the third game, but man, that fourth game, that was sweet. I don't know how to describe, like, I've never been in this position before.
You said that the you saw every single member of that crowd. When they were going crazy for those kills, was that giving you more energy, making you guys even more emphatic about this win?
I mean, when you're starting to lose your voice a bit, and you don't have to scream as loudly, it feels like you just have extra energy. Like every spell you do is like extra 50 damage, and all your auto attacks are like double damage for like forever. And I don't know, it's so cool.
The presence of the stage, that's what some of them call it. At one point in that game or the series, were you guys confident you were walking away as world champions?
I think we were really confident, like, just from the start, from the really get-go. We kind of knew the third game that they were going to try and surprise us. So we were not really surprised when they did do something so crazy as they did.
Sure.
And I don't think that we allowed them to do it in the last game where they wanted to do the same thing. And we just, you know, played smarter, I think. I don't know how to... I don't know what to say.
That's all right. I understand. You've got a lot going on right now. But let's take it back about a week or so, or even to Friday, when you guys went 4-4 in the LAN Center, or a week before you had even gotten here. Did you expect to come to your first LAN, a World Finals, and bring it home?
No. Honestly, no. Never. We wanted to get Grand Final, top two. Now we did end top two. We won it, and I think we exceeded all expectations. I don't think anybody could have like expected us to do this good.
What is next for you and the Bad Monkey Gaming team? You sticking around here in Thailand? You're gonna be doing a little bit of celebration?
Yeah, there's a party tonight, I heard. Also, we have like until Saturday before we go home, so that's gonna be pretty sweet, just relaxing. Enjoying each other, like, you know.
You guys all seem like pretty damn good friends.
Yeah, like boot camping and being together at like this event and all, it has definitely like helped so much. Like meeting people in person, right? Like people you've been talking and playing with for 2.5 years, some of it's like, I don't know, you're just like best friends forever, kind of.
It seems like that when we were seeing you. And of course, we have our next event 2.5 months away on the home country of most of your team here, DreamHack Summer. Are we going to see a repeat performance and the start of a new dynasty with a back-to-back LAN win?
Maybe Sync won't choke, but hopefully we will actually face them and show them what we have like in store for them.
And prove you're the best.
Exactly.
Absolutely. All right, guys. Congratulations one more time to Root of Z. Root, the mic is yours if you want to say anything to your friends, family, team, or all of the fans watching at home.
Shout out to my friends watching. I was Skyping with them from the stage. They are incredibly good at supporting me and my gaming career. Shout out to all my fans, especially the ones that kept whispering me to pick more Riftwalker. I love that hero. I love playing it. And I love, you know, hearing how awesome I am on it. Shout out to my sponsor, BMG, and all the sponsors of BMG. INED, QBAD, etc. I don't know them on my head. I don't have the energy to think them through. And yeah, it's been really awesome here. I want to shout out to the event crew. Like, they've made it really easy to be here and play. It has been super smooth, no problems. We just go to our computer, set up, play. We get food, we get drinks. Everything has been amazing. And the hotel was really great. I'm really happy that we stayed at such a nice place. It has definitely helped us prepare and be rested. And yeah, I mean, thank you for,
of course,
for letting me be here and play. As always, we're having fun.
Always. All right, guys, live from Bangkok, Thailand. I'm with Root of Z and the champions, Bad Monkey Gaming. We're going to throw it back to Breaky and Swindle to wrap this up.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. So that officially is going to do it. Root of Z there, of course, doing the interview. Definitely had some fun stuff to say. And BMG, once again, they are your world champions of 2015. So we're going to start wrapping up ourselves here as far as our coverage goes. Kyle, thanks for coming out. A lot of fun, man. It was great having you here, you know, being the returning champion and all. So I'm sure it was fun for you as well. So
yeah, I brought the uniform, like, all the way from home. I figured I had to wear it for at least the goodbyes. You know, it was really weird not being Stay Green Swindlemelons at this event, but I had a good time, and I'm really glad BMG were able to take it home, especially because, you know, the organization's put a lot of effort into Han, and they came up short last year. I'm glad they got a championship.
Yeah.
I think Boxy's actually in tears. He's so happy, which I've been there before. You know, just good guys.
Yeah.
They deserve the win.
Yeah, they do. They really do. They're definitely very prepared. Like I said, they've been a team for so long, so definitely deserving of the win. And a big congratulations to them once again on that. So any shout-outs you want to make? Anything else?
You know, big shout-out to my family, as always.
Okay.
They're supporting and watching me cast Han, even though, you know, I don't think we even play it that much anymore. And getting a lot of love from friends and family on Facebook and just messages. My girlfriend came out, and she's going to be in Thailand for the next 2 months, and, you know, it was cool spending time with her. Everyone still, you know, it'd been a year since I saw any of you guys.
Yeah, and I know.
I just love everybody
like
so much.
Times.
It's like, it's just always good. You know, Han's one of the best. It's got the greatest ecosystem, I think, in all of esports. You won't see many opportunities for, you'll have production, S2, casters, and members of three different teams just all huddled together, playing together. You know, we drink at night with like 25 people, three different regions. Everybody's great. If I didn't have a flight in 2 hours, I'd certainly be out with them tonight, you know.
Gotta get out of
40.
Here.
But anyway, it was just really glad I could be here. Thanks to everybody and the fans for all the support and the well wishes. I'm going to just give you a hug real quick.
Here,
Breaky. Good to see you, man.
Awkward hug, huh?
Yeah, well, whatever, man.
It was
Hopefully
fun.
I'll be back eventually, but
definitely.
Who knows?
Hey, definitely.
Life is weird. Anyway, Mini.
Thanks again.
Come here.
Gotta get Mini in here, of course, to wrap up as well, so.
I knocked the mic off, but anyway.
Thanks again.
Have a good stream. Thank you very much. Here you go, Mini.
There you go, guys. Swindlemelons there. So, signing out. Now we got Mini here. Mini, what a season it was.
What a season and what a great event to finish off, Breaky. I mean,
wow.
It feels like all the work we did back in August makes it all the best.
Hey,
you know?
How's it going? Oh, we're just having lovey now. That's what we do at the end of these. Yeah, I mean, throughout this whole season, again, who would have thought, like I said, BMG, a team that we didn't really know anything about, then known as Willow Keeper, you know, going into the season, that these guys would, at the end of it all, be your world champions, and definitely coming over a lot of adversity going into this event. Again, that was the biggest thing. So, but we don't want to keep too long here. Mini, any final words? Any
final words? Obviously, congratulations to BMG. I think really at the whole tournament, they probably were the best team at the end of the day, and they deserved the win. So congratulations to them in terms of shout-outs. A shout-out to Nelstone Gaming, St. Rocks, ProBosk, all my family and friends back at home, George, Jazz, Vince, Fred, Tino, Kai. Sorry, I had to get the long list. But also, thanks to you, Breaky. Obviously, without you, I wouldn't be here in the first place. Thanks to S2 and everyone, man. It's like a dream come true. It really is, honestly. I know it sounds a little bit cliche, but I remember being like a small little viewer back at home, Homecast viewer. And now I'm here in Bangkok, Thailand. Mate. It means a lot. It really, really does.
Awesome. It was fun, man. It was a fun season, and definitely more to come, I'm sure. But what a season it was, and looking back at that. So thanks to you for being the co-caster, and it was awesome. So with that said as well, I actually got a special announcement here. Apparently, Root of Z is doing a giveaway with his jersey. We do that in Twitch chat, I guess, or? Sure, okay. Let's see, he's going to be signing his jersey, and we're going to be doing that in Twitch chat, so stick around for that, guys. At the end of the broadcast here, we'll do that. And if you want a chance to win Root of Z's signed Bad Monkey Gaming shirt, that's going to be worth some money, man. That's going to be worth some money as far as on the market there.
Boop, 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 boop.
All money cash. Mini, so thanks once again, man. See, we got to do the hug now.
We got the hug.
Everyone else has been doing the hug. Oh, great season, man. Great season. Love to all. Love to the production, obviously. They did a fantastic job once again, and great working with them once again. Shout out to Beef, of course, as we saw over there, and the job that he did. And everyone here, the crew behind the scenes and whatnot, just did a fantastic job. I mean, I know things like this, they're not easy.
No, they're really not.
They're not easy. There's a lot that goes on behind the scenes, but we made it work, and I think it's safe to say we're very successful, very happy with the result here and how it all played out. So big shout out to everybody involved, of course, here at the Haunt Tour Season 3 World Final. So with that said, going to be wrapping up officially. Shout out to you guys, as always, for tuning in. Shout out to Kelsey. I love you. I love you, big. Oh, I had to get with that one in there. And shout out to, again, to everyone else. Everyone else, of course. I love you all, of course. But a little bit more. Anyways, the World Finals of 2015 are officially coming to an end. We got one more video to recap, see how it went out. Have a good night, guys.